Hi, it's Grizzlebox Locks, back with a lock how-to. I was asked to demonstrate how I get my rope twist or double strand twist to stay. So on one side, I'm going to do the double strand twist, and then the other side, I'll do the rope twist. So for the rope twist, what I did was I used 4 locks, 2 on each side, and I rolled each lock towards the left a few times and then cross it over. Roll it, same direction, I'm going towards the left and then cross it over. And I think that's the key for the lock to stay without unraveling. You have to make sure you're rolling it and crossing over, rolling it in the same direction and just crossing it over. Now I don't have a rubber band, so I'm just going to show you how it stays. And I'll go ahead and do another one. There it is. So again, for the rope twist, you're going to need 4 strands of locks, 2 on each side, and just roll it in the same direction and then cross it over. Now for the double strand twist, I usually use 2 locks. And again, no rubber band, and it stays. Now this is what happens when you don't twist or roll the lock before you cross it over. All right, so if you just go ahead and just start twisting the locks, it's gonna unravel. All right, so here's just the twist without rolling the locks. And here's the twist with rolling the locks. And as you can see, I'm shaking both, and eventually The one that's not rolled before you cross it over unravels quicker than the one that is twisted and rolled before you cross it over. So, there you go. And that's how I get my rope twist and double strand twist to stay. Eventually I would put rubber bands in the end just to secure it. I hope this helps. Until next time, keep it natural, keep it locked, keep it you.